So I'm Hannah Giancola. I'm studying furniture design at RIT, and I'm in the master's program. I have a background in industrial design for my bachelor's, and then now I am studying for my master's in furniture. My background is mostly in metalworking and metal fabrication, and also in textiles and leatherworking. So coming into furniture was kind of a switch in learning about a new material, learning about wood from the beginning, from what is a material, from how it grows, how it's cut, and then how to use it and machine it. So I have a repair shop, it's called The Upside, which I came up with the name kind of because I felt like optimism was something that I had to like lead with. It's a lot of bags, clothing, shoes. I think one of my favorite things is when somebody has an object that might not be very expensive, but they've just had it and they want to keep it in their lives, or they've gotten it from somebody that was really meaningful to them, and we get to come up with a solution to let them keep it for longer and just always have it. This semester we're working on a project that is to make a reliquary, so a place to hold something that is precious to us. It could be an idea, it could be a space, it could be people in our lives, it could be an object. I'm making a reliquary for a box set of VHS tapes from my favorite films from when I was a kid. So a lot of innovation and creativity and kind of that at-home inventor, which was really inspiring to me as a kid. And I think kind of was instrumental in me wanting to tinker with things and build things. It's a series of pulleys and fixtures and mechanisms that just are playful and fun. I started this program last semester, and we start with kind of a simple project, which is just using hand tools. So all of our brand new tools that we are not acquainted with yet, we kind of do a crash course in learning how to use those and how to do things absolutely from scratch. But you get to be a part of every single moment of the making of the piece. So this one was a fully hand-tooled table. The inspiration came from wanting to experiment with design, and I also wanted to think about how I could kind of suspend a very organic form kind of over a ledge. A really big part of being in school, which I think is one of the biggest benefits, is that we critique everything and we discuss it to length with all of our peers and then even people that are outside of our immediate program. So when I finished this table, which was the first part of the semester, I got a lot of feedback asking me why I designed something that was difficult for people to use. This second piece here was a reaction to the first piece, but also a reaction to the feedback I got, which was, you know, why do I make choices when I design? I was still thinking about contrasting shapes, so still some geometric versus organic shapes, and, you know, personally with family that's being affected by current events, I chose to make a piece about how people get to interact in conversation, specifically about conflict and specifically people that have opposing views. And so I chose to make a table that was really supposed to be aiding in conversation. So when we think about design, you're trying to lead people to use your design in a certain way. And so I thought a lot about, okay, if I want to face somebody in a conversation, I need to have a table that has two distinct sides so that we know that we're supposed to be across from each other. My most used tool is my combination squares because everything is based on being able to construct at true 90 degrees. But my favorite tool is just pencils. I'm a pencil aficionado. We also had a project that we did this semester simultaneously that was to create an heirloom tool. And I decided on a pencil. Which is slightly disposable because you sharpen it. But I just thought about the fact that I use pencils every single day. I always prefer them. But I was really trying to strip it down to what is needed to make a pencil. Basically, you need a way to hold the graphite that's going to make the marks. But the really great thing about graphite is that it's erasable. Oh, I think one thing that I've learned over and over and over again is, first of all, work smarter, not harder. And once you measure something and you make a part, instead of measuring again, you just use the one part that you made and you replicate it. And that way you're always working from the part that you want it to end up to be. A lot of times I get so much tunnel vision in what I'm making and what I'm creating. And I think my biggest shop hack would be to back up from my work and then you glaringly can see problems or, you know, what's working and what isn't working.